Coming up on this week's news, a consulting engineer issues a stark warning to the trade about untested solar panels. Octopus says it's setting up a club to decide the standards for smart electrical kit, and how an electrical contractor is using artificial intelligence to make big savings. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to access their online store. Whether you're listening in the van, on-site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. A consulting engineer and fire expert has issued a stark warning to the trade about untested solar panels. Luke Gonzalez says there's been a significant increase in their use in installations where the PV modules are integrated into the building's fabric. He says their inclusion will almost certainly not comply with current UK building regulations. They will also, in turn, invalidate any certificate issued by MCS, the watchdog for the installation of domestic renewable energy. Gonzalez, who runs a fire safety and building services consultancy in Cardiff, says installers have a duty of care to ensure that the products they're installing are suitably compliant and are safe for use. In his professional opinion, he says they should not be making any assumptions of compliance on this matter. Gonzalez knows the specific brand of solar panels involved, but won't name it publicly. He says the products could be putting homeowners at risk and invalidating insurance policies, and that he's raised the issue with the manufacturer to no avail. Gonzalez has asked if the company involved should not at least notify their customers of the importance of only using suitably tested modules. Or, he says, would they rather say nothing, watch it unfold and be complicit in its non-compliance? The consultant has also alerted various UK associations and certifications. Recently, Gonzalez has taken to social media with his concerns. It's understood that behind the scenes, the MCS is exploring this issue. It's expected that the body will publish an explanatory statement in the coming weeks. In other news, Octopus has revealed that it's setting up a club to decide the standards for smart electrical kit. The energy giant surprised the trade with the announcement that it's inviting other firms and utilities to join an alliance dubbed Project Mercury. This body will write the clean tech standards so that electrical equipment, utilities and grid operators can all talk to each other. Octopus says it already manages what it terms the world's largest virtual power plant. This comprises over 200,000 connected devices, including solar panels, EV chargers, batteries, thermostats and heat pumps. In total, it represents over 1 gigawatt of power, which can be flexibly deployed. Octopus says that the global consortium of hardware manufacturers will simplify the integration of the 200 million pieces of clean tech kit that are predicted to be in use by 2030. Devices which use the standard will be known as Mercury-enabled. The communication protocol will allow energy grid operators to balance the load by controlling appliances such as battery packs, freezers and EV chargers. Octopus says it will also drive the uptake of smart energy tariffs. Octopus founder and Archbishop of Energy, Greg Jackson, says he sees Project Mercury is similar to the development of Bluetooth, which set a global standard for tech devices. The standard could eventually help balance the electrical load in Ireland, where it's been revealed that just 92 data centres now account for over a fifth of the nation's electricity. In fact, 64 of the buildings use between 10 and 50 megawatts of power. 50 megawatts is enough to power a town the size of Reading. Two-thirds of these are accounted for by what are termed hyperscale operators, which include Amazon Web Services, Microsoft, Meta, and Google. The research was compiled by BitPower Consultants. Still on technology, an electrical contractor in America says he's worked out how to use artificial intelligence to make significant savings. Eric Owski, boss of Treehouse, says one of the biggest costs for his firm is sending out an electrician to site. If there's any uncertainty over an installation, the first thing he used to do was send out a van. Not anymore. Now, for 90% of jobs such as EV chargers, no van is sent out prior to the install day. For those jobs, Treehouse asks the customer a handful of questions, such as what are the major uses of electricity in their home, like water heaters. That helps the company determine if the homeowner will need to upgrade their electrical connection or main panel. For more complex jobs, the company will ask the homeowner to submit more details, including photos of their home's disboard. If the company still needs more information, it'll try a virtual visit with the customer, and only if that fails, it'll roll a van. Treehouse then quotes the job, designs the installation, and applies for any permits. While it has its own workforce of electricians, it often hands that off to a local independent electrician to do the work. It's a business model that's becoming more common in the United States. Would it work in the UK? Let us know what you think in the comments. And if you're not quite ready for AI electricians but still want to learn more about your trade, our last question of the week was lifted from our free training package on industrial socket outlets made with Lude and Palazzoli. The question was, for a socket outlet supplying a caravan pitch, which of the following statements is true? The RCD protection must disconnect, and of course the correct answer was all live conductors. 85% of you got it right on YouTube, and for the first time in a long time, even more of you on LinkedIn got it right with 91%. Meanwhile, on X, the platform formerly known as Twitter, a very respectable 79% nailed it. Be sure to check out that free training package, which is now fully updated to incorporate Amendment 2, by clicking the link in the show notes. Now, over 800,000 electricity meters are set to be replaced in the coming months in an urgent upgrade program. The reason? The long-wave radio signal, which tells them to switch between on and off-peak, is set to be turned off next summer. The outdated units, known as radio teleswitch or RTS meters, have traditionally been used to switch storage heaters or immersion heaters on at night. They enabled special tariffs such as Economy 7. If the meters are not replaced in time, some homes, schools and businesses could be left without heating and hot water. The other possibility is that they won't be able to turn off their heating. A meter upgrade takes around 2 hours to complete, but some jobs can be more complex if a DNO is needed or if a unit is not accessible. Electricians are being asked to advise any of their customers with an RTS meter to contact their energy supplier immediately. A big thanks to our correspondent Sergio Fernandez from the Costa del Watford for the heads up on that story. And if you want to hear an interesting story about the time an Economy 7 tariff was waylaid, ask Gordon about his 5-year battle with his energy provider. It makes for a great story. In EV news, Nissan says that soon its electric cars will be able to power up homes. The Japanese giant is planning to introduce two-way charging on some of its vehicles from 2026. The initiative will start to be rolled out in the UK and then to other European countries. Vehicle-to-grid technology allows motorists to either power their homes using their car's battery or sell it back to the grid. Nissan was the first automaker to gain the right to upload power to the UK grid. It estimates that the function could potentially halve the annual cost of powering an electric vehicle. In product news, Fluke has unveiled a digital multimeter and clamp aimed at electricians working on solar installs. The 283 FC meter and wireless clamp are designed to test individual photovoltaic panels, strings or inverters in large-scale arrays. With the addition of Staubli MC4 test leads, you can make secure connections to modules or strings to test DC voltages of up to 1,500 volts. A special unit has been unveiled which makes it easy to upgrade lights from fluorescent to LED. The rhesus is designed to replace existing T5 and T8 fluorescent tubes. The light stays in the ceiling and the design of the rhesus allows it to sit in the existing fluorescent lamp holders. But crucially, it only uses them as a mechanical fix, not as an electrical connection. Instead, it's powered by a remote driver which sits in the ceiling. The existing ballast is bypassed. This avoids all the technical issues associated with LED tubes. Rhesus has just been recognised by the judges of the Build Back Better Awards. They've given it both a gold and a green award, so congratulations to the Regen initiative which developed the product. Finally, the big promotion this autumn is from BG Circuit Protection, and it's just gone live. Installers who buy a product from the BG Circuit Protection range will get entered into a draw whose top prize is a European city break. So soon you could be sipping port in Porto, beer in Bratislava, or vodka in Vilnius? The runner-up prizes aren't too shabby either. They include a Porsche driving experience, an annual pass for Merlin theme parks and attractions, and a smart TV. To enter, buy a product from the range. Accessories are not included. Upload your receipt or invoice to the special BG website, and, well, that's it. I've popped a link to the competition website in the show notes. The promotion ends on Tuesday the 10th of December. All the very best, everyone. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. As we transition into November, we'll be looking at commercial EV charging, testing equipment and innovations within the electrical industry. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry, it's SunSync. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home, it's Envirovent. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since stainless steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables, and with an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart, it's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were catfish and galoshes, and I obviously did a really bad job of hiding them, as simply loads of you got both of them. But the winner we plucked from our digital hat was Jason FKM5MQ. So well done to you. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click the link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.